You need to do something with your hair. Today is the day. It is the Sydney Vegan Festival and we will be talking. I'm not gonna lie, I'm kind of shitting my pants about this one, but
I'm actually scared that I might wet myself on stage. I would have two pairs of undies on.
2 seconds ago he was like, no, this is totally fine, we got this, like just have fun with it.
Yeah, but this is like my confidence levels, they're like here, and then they're here, and then just before we go on stage, they're gonna be ksh.
Oh, that's, I thought you were gonna say just before we go on stage, they're gonna be choo. So there's this salon around the corner for me that like contacted me and asked to buy like a whole heap of my books to like gift their customers, which is like really nice. And then I was like, it's actually an ebook, but I can print it out for you guys. So I printed it out and I'm going to drop them off. They were like, when you drop them off, we can like give you like a free like style or color or whatever. And I was like, hang on, wait, I'm going to the Sydney Vegan Festival today, so maybe I'll get them to do like make my hair look like half decent. Maybe we'll see. Because I have a bit of a watermelon theme going on. I have watermelon on my keys. I have a watermelon wallet. And do you know what I just realized? I even have a watermelon phone case. Take my doggy one off. Come look at my cute little stash.
Yeah, I like the theme.
You know what I really want to do now? Is change my keys and get one cut that color and the other cut that color. Oh. And then they'll be like green and pink keys.
My god.
Here are my beautiful books. Dun dun dun. 10. So, here is my end result. We use this amazing, like, is it a new vegan product? Hey.
Yes.
It's like a mousse. I think I'm gonna get this one.
The whole brand is up here if you wanna have a look.
I love the bottles as well. Like, they're so funky. And this is all vegan.
Back with your talk today.
Thank you so much. Bye. Okay, so I'm just gonna get a juice while I'm out because it's a juice place right next to here. I'm gonna get that Zane. I've got my juice. Well, it's actually more like a smoothie, but it tastes really healthy. Like, where is the sugar? It's just not quite sweet enough, you know? Really?
When did you crack the screen?
What do you mean the screen's cracked?
It's cracked. There.
It's cracked there.
Naughty! I knew you dropped it the other day.
I finished my like average smoothie. It's kind of filling though. And I'm now having some oats and some bananas, some cornflakes. Also some raspberries. To calm down my nerves, I'm gonna sit here and watch all of Bite Size Vegan's videos because she knows everything about veganism. I'm kind of freaking out about talking in front of thousands of people.
No, it's just like Tumblr.
I'll just pretend it's Tumblr and blow up on stage.
Oh my god, I'm so fucking stoked for you, Bunny.
You're freaking me out even more now.
No, sorry. It's me, Matt. You deserve it. You really do.
Just had my little prep talk with Steph. She always makes me feel better. I love her so much.
Always waiting there. No one ever.
Hi. My god, I wasn't recording that whole time. I just told you guys so much and my camera wasn't recording, so I'm gonna tell you again. Firstly, I'm so nervous I wanna vomit. And I need to do a poo.
I'm so jaded for this now.
And I'm sweating.
The party has arrived.
What are we eating?
Mexican.
Where's the Mexican place?
Yeah.
Let's line up, shall we? Fonzie!
Oh!
I wanted to get that on camera.
I'm dying for them. I'm so nervous.
Does anybody know Bonnie Rebecca and Tim O'Kane? These two young people, your fans out there, are two of the most influential vegan bloggers within Australia, making them internet sensations. These two people are leading the way in the social change movement and are icons of gods in their own right. Let's give a very big applause to Bonnie and Tim.
When I was about 16, I was training at a Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu school. The head trainer there and one of the fighters were like vegan. And they were like, dude, you gotta stop eating meat and dairy. Like, it's just hindering your performance. And I was like, alright, you guys are way better than me. I'm gonna listen to you. So they gave me some books. I started slowly cutting out animal products. By the time I was 18, I pretty much was eating no animal products, but I hadn't found an ethical connection.
When I met Tim, we were working at a bar together. He was this weird boy who brought in like fruits and watermelon, and
I'd bring the watermelon in for dinner at
yeah
night.
I just thought it was crazy.
I'd be like eating lettuce before our shift started. I'd have packets of sultanas in my pockets like mid-shift so I could eat.
But I was intrigued, so I started asking everyone. I was like, who is this guy that eats watermelons all day, like what's going on? He said, I'm vegan. And I was just like, what? Tim was like obviously such a good support system. He was like making my meals, and like we were in the bar together, and he was like chopping up mangoes, and like, you know, we were like preparing all our meals together and stuff. So I just felt like so amazing that I could never go back. And that's when we watched Earthlings together, and like we made that ethical decision, the connection together. And that's when like we became so passionate about it. We're like, oh, you know, maybe we should start trying to tell other people how much this has helped us.
And then in the mornings I'd make her a banana smoothie and then put on some of Freely's videos, and she would just sit there sipping her smoothie, watching Freely.
What is the most important aspect of the triangle for you guys now that you know the depth of each of the ethics, environment and yeah health? What is the most important to keep vegan people vegan long term?
I think ethics by far now. I just could never ever imagine eating an animal product again.
Yeah, like even if we went and like ate a junk food vegan diet or whatever, like we would way rather do that than ever go back to eating animal products. It's definitely a complete ethical thing for us now. Like once you make that connection that what you're eating is an animal, or what you're eating is a byproduct of cruelty. Just, I could never walk into a field and kill a cow. And that was the moment I realised that, why am I paying someone else to do it for me?
Hey guys, hi. You are super hot, both of you.
Like our main exercise is cycling.
We ride one day and we go to the gym the other day.
Yeah, so we also do strength stuff just because we like it.
Hey Bonnie. Yes, what does the t-shirt say, and we get it wrong?
It says, cows are for mooing, not barbecuing. How many times do we eat out a week? Usually once a week. Yeah, on average, once a week. YouTube, I think, is like probably one of the most effective. You can really like connect with the people that are on it, and you get to know them, and you can really tell if the person, kind of person that they are and what they're promoting and all that kind of stuff. Whereas Instagram can be fake and can be a complete misrepresentation of their life. So, and I think people get really mixed up in that, and they start idolizing people that they don't even know their life, you know? And of course, not everyone puts up their lows on Instagram. It's usually just their highlights. So I think YouTube is, share all of it. Do it a bit more transparent, yeah.
What would be the best to make your boyfriend go vegan?
I would say conform, okay, and make sure that he's not missing out on anything. Because that's it, like, as long as they find something tasty, they're not gonna care. And you can put on some videos in the background, maybe when he's having dinner. Keep in mind that it might take a bit of time as well. Yeah.
We're just sort of wrapping up now. Awesome. Yeah. Is there something you'd like to add?
I'd like to say thanks to everyone for being a really nice audience.
We're done!
Yay!
Yay!
Get some food.
How did we go, Joey?
Oh, we did well. It was a great time. Vegan Illuminati World Tour.
Yeah.
Happening soon.
Very good. Didn't seem nervous at all.
Okay, good.
Stools like really chill you out.
The stools were good.
I told you the stools.
Yeah, Q&A is a good idea.
Oh, that was fucking awesome. Like, everyone was so lovely and it just felt so awesome talking in front of everyone. And afterwards, everyone was coming up and asking questions and talking, taking photos. So it was just really good to communicate, like, to connect with everyone. And I just feel so good getting that off my chest. They invited us to the Perth one as well, so that's really cool.
December.
So, yeah, we're gonna go to Perth because I've never been there before.
I want to go to Perth.
Okay, you can come with us. Let's go to dinner. All the vegan places are packed. Like, that is so good to see.
Running off a high after that. I'm not gonna be able to sleep all night.
I know, me either. Like, really nervous at first, and then we went on stage and we're like, oh, and then we had each other, so it was like really easy to like bounce off each other. And like,
I think I just remembered like, why are we doing this, you know?
Yeah, everyone we met afterwards were like awesome, and it really inspires you, hey.
I just appreciate people coming up and saying hello because you know, you just make friends. And
We didn't freak out on stage.
I didn't make too much of a fool of myself.
You were funny. If you came today or you said hello today or anything like that, then I just want to say thank you and we love you guys. Oh, that's what I was going to say. Also, the guy we went to dinner with, his name is Joey and he is so fucking awesome. His channel is called Joey Carbstrong and I'm going to link it down below because I think everyone should check him out and go give him some happiness gains. Anyway, all right. Ow. Okay. Did you really just need to do that? Oh, my battery's just about to die. Perfect timing. My camera's telling me to shut the fuck up. I will see you guys next time. Bye.
Bye.